Before we can work with Krita, we obviously have to install it. In order to do so, head to krita.org, the official website, and click on the download link at the top of the page. There are three different distributions of Krita called Krita Desktop, Gemini, and Studio. We are only interested in the first one. If you scroll down the page a little bit, you can see that there is a version available for Linux, a version for Windows, and also a version for Mac. Currently, Krita is only officially supported on Windows and Linux. The Mac version is experimental, but the developers announced that they want to support it officially in the future, and they are working on it. Linux users, I invite you to follow the steps provided on the official website to install Krita. I'm a Windows user myself, so this doesn't make any sense to me. For the Windows users, just download the package that fits your computer. And while it is downloading, it's a great occasion to update your graphic drivers. It's very important to do so before you install Krita. Then, you just have to run the MSE file, which will allow you to choose where you want to install Krita. That's it, you can now run the application and start working with it. For advanced users, unstable versions are released frequently. They give access to the latest features in development in Krita, but they are more likely to crash. Those versions are portable, so you can try them out without messing up your stable install of Krita. The latest animation beta contains the new rendering engine and the animation toolset that are coming to Krita 3. If you want to, you can try it out before Krita 3 is released. You can find it in the news section of the official website. Oh, and know that I won't provide any support on those unstable builds.